Welcome to Manarat.
Welcome to Manarat.
Welcome to Manarat.
Welcome to Manarat.
Founded in 1977 by Prince Mohammed Al-Faisal, Manarat Jeddah International School
has a long history of delivering a high standard of education to boys and girls in Jeddah. In 2004, Ma'arif acquired Manarat, and their continued support has brought many improvements to the school. In this video, we will show you what life in Manarat is like for boys like me.
سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون ينزل الملائكة من روح من أمره على من يشاء من عباده أن أنذروا أنه لا إله إلا أنا فاتقون
Now I'd like to take you from this grade 3 social studies class to a grade 8 Islamic studies class. Here they are, completely different subjects and completely different grade. But there's a factor which is common between the two, and that's that you see them doing group work, sharing ideas. Let's see what one of the students think about this.
I thought the work was good, and how I chose the people to do the work, I chose like the best writer to write the sentences, the best drawer to draw, and the leader, he just bosses everyone around. And the drawer, I chose him because he knows how to draw. And I think work is good because teamwork is good because you can finish quick.
Hello, my name is Leanne. Welcome to KJ3E.
I like to come to school to learn. All day I learn something new.
Studying Merchant of Venice. We found Merchant of Venice difficult to read, but by the time it will be easy if you read it two times or three times and to translate the word by internet.
it is a very good place to fresh your mind. Reading is interesting. You can find the books that are in this.
Hello, my name is Manarat Jeddah, and I like Manarat International School. And I like to go to the library and read some books, and I like to listen to the books.
Hi, my name is Hala. I'm 1C student. I like the spelling bee because I learned new words and I had fun.
The University of Cambridge Local Examination Syndicate, as it was then called, introduced the IGCSE in 1988. Now we started, we switched over from GCSE O level to IGCSE in 1990, 2 years after its introduction. And ever since we've been doing the IGCSE, our results have been extremely brilliant. Over the years, we've had many top achieving students at various levels of the examination. We introduced the A level in 1992-93, and that was the first in the region. We're the first school to introduce A-level in the region, and this has been going on parallel with the IGCSE. Over the years, we've had very, very top achieving pupils. I do remember Sohail, Muhammad Warith, and they achieved the top level in biology and physics in the region. Muhammad Abdul Wahab in 2011 got the best in mathematics worldwide, along with another student who got the best in English for the region. Subsequently, we've also had a lot of achievement with Muhammad Abdul Wahab, with Arif Jawad, with Ziad Ayman, and lately with Muhammad and Ahmed Naheen. This has been, a brilliant achievement over the years. This is quite indicative of the effort that the school has always put in developing its own pupils to the very, very top level. We continue to work very hard to ensure that now and in the future we would achieve much better results, that would match any institution worldwide.
الله لمن حمده suffering from grief after losing her companion for so many years. And today we received the news that mother died also. Allah yarham. So this is life. This is what something I mentioned to you previously. A lot of your teachers which you have in front of you in your classrooms, you don't realize the sacrifices many of them have made. Traveled from their home countries, left behind their families, their mothers, their fathers. And many of them I've seen over the years. The next time they see them.
Mr. Latif has been giving us talks during the Salah break for years, mashallah, since I can remember. So some of the benefits from these talks are that it helps us learn our religion better, and it's a way of getting young Muslims to understand their religion in a better way, because many people have misconceptions and misunderstandings about Islam. So Mr. Latif tries to set those straight by giving these talks. Another one is that many Muslims nowadays are ignorant about their about the rulings or various teachings of Islam. So Mr. Latif tries, again, he tries to get the Muslims to know their religion better and tries to get the Muslims to know about the things they're ignorant about. It also provides a nice break for the day after a long, busy day of studying chemistry, physics, biology, maths. It provides a nice break during Salah to, you know, get to know the religion better. And it also provides a better focus on the religion, on religious issues, so that it can benefit you in the hereafter, inshallah.
Grade 1 is very important for many reasons. First and foremost, it's like the big school for the kids. Most of them have gone to KG, so they have a background of English knowledge and education in general. But when they come to grade 1, it's like a new school, a new arena for them, and there's a lot that they start to learn.
Okay, so the first thing that we do is we introduce classroom rules, and that's within the first few weeks to get everybody in line with how the class should be set and how discipline should be conducted in the class. After that point, we continue with learning, and learning can be done in many ways. Obviously, we try to follow the constructivist theory with scaffolding, but we also use the Bloom's taxonomy for the children to progressively build on what they're already learning in the class, and we do that in a fun, interactive way. By keeping the children active and motivated, you're really engaging them in everything that they do. So if we go on to reading, for example, we read every single day, one lesson a day. The children read, and they're learning new words, they're learning new phonics, and there's phonemic awareness in nearly every lesson of reading. And at the same time, we've set homework for them, which is the story of the week, which they read every day again. Using the interactive board is very, very beneficial. Children can't wait to get on the interactive smart board. They're really engaged with it. Alhamdulillah, working with in groups. Each group is competing with each other to try and earn extra points so that they can win stars at the end of the week. The computer lab is also another excellent way of introducing the keyboard and how a computer works and how technology is progressing in these days. They're using it, they're enjoying it, and it's excellent that they have that opportunity now that they're in a big school, as they see it. We do at times have trips twice a term, with going to the aquarium. The stuff that we learn in science is obviously it's good on the interactive board, which is a very nice way to learn, but they also have the opportunity to go to places like the aquarium where they can actually see the living things, where we cover the chapter of living and non-living things, so that they can actually see it in real life.
My name is Faraz, I'm grade 1 student, and
we paint. I love the art lesson. In the last art lesson, we painted the clock and we put numbers on it.
In water, right?
In we go. Oh, it's...
Oh!
Okay, now we test your chemistry. What is that gas? Baking soda. Is sodium bicarb? Is spongy not hold it well?
25 degrees. 25 degrees, that's
me too. 1, 2, 3. Ah, almost. It's a mess. Then the structure is still intact.
1, 2, 3.
There you go.
Hovercraft.
Oh, bad breath craft, you could call it. Actually.
The experiment is about finding the temperature difference when adding the Fe2 into the acid by putting the thermometer and measuring the temperature difference, the initial and the highest. Then we calculate the enthalpy change.
So is this a type of reaction?
Yes, it's an exothermic reaction.
How did the mass of Fe1 be needed to change the temperature, which we recorded by the thermometer, mm-hmm. to see the temperature change, how the temperature changes from 28 degrees Celsius. 23 degrees Celsius, and we're going to draw
a
graph about it.
It makes the students appreciate the concepts that they do in theory, because when they're able to apply the theory in practice, for example, they're now determining enthalpy changes. Now, they've done it in theory, but doing the practice measures. Now, in theory, they just give them the values, but when they do the practice, they actually know the relevance of the theory. The second thing is that also coaches them to do practical work, which actually the skills in measurement, the skills in evaluation, the skills in analysis are all learned during the practicals. This is the basis of it.
Exactly. Yeah.
Forbes.
The geoboard, it's used to make polygons, and polygons are closed figures with line segments and vertices.
My name is Zuna, and these are the polygons I made, and they're closed figures.
My name is Yamar. As you can see, here I made a face with different polygons. I have two hexagons and one quadrilateral.
Parents' evening was very beneficial. It allowed us to make the connection with the parents because we have a common goal. And that common goal is the betterment and the enrichment of our children. So with parents' evening and things such as WhatsApp communication and email, you will find that Manarat is very, very, very proud and very, very, very excited about the connection that we have with the parents.
I am Ali Qureshi.
And I'm Nabil Khan.
And we are the leaders of Manarat Jeddah International School Student Council. We at Student Council do a variety of community service activities, with one of them being our orphanage donation program, in which we collect donations monthly throughout the whole school. All staff and students are encouraged to donate, and also any other people they know outside of school can give them donations which they could give to the school. Yeah, once all donations are collected, they are sent to a local orphanage, and we hope this program becomes a norm and is done every year in the school from now on.
We have already collected the first batch of donations this month. It was truly nice to see that all the teachers, the parents, and the students, they donated a lot.
The donations we received included a variety of different items such as toys, clothes, and sanitary wares such as soaps and tissues.
Last October, we raised awareness about not littering and taking care of the environment around us. We did this by declaring the Environmental Week, during which we urged students not to litter, and also we had seniors doing presentations to explain where exactly our garbage goes. During the week, we had a variety of activities that took place. For example, the students made posters. We also had writing competitions, and at the end of the week, we also had a debate. After the week, we noticed significant improvements in the cleanliness of our school, so I believe this was a success.
Although we call it the Environmental Week, one of our main goals is to actually affect the way students and people think towards the environment for hopefully the rest of their entire lives.
Therefore, we made them pledge, we made them promise that they would not that they would not litter, and that they would take real actions to improve their lifestyle choices. So inshallah, we hope that there will be improvements